Hi, let's talk about the laryngeal cartilages, aka the laryngoskeleton. In this video, we'll discuss the major cartilaginous parts of the laryngoskeleton and relate important features of these cartilages to the structure and functions of the larynx. But first, what is the larynx? The larynx, or colloquially the voice box, is the most proximal part of the dedicated respiratory tract. Anything more proximal to this is going to be a shared aerodigestive pathway. It is inferior to the hyoid bone. It hangs from the hyoid bone by the thyrohyoid membrane, and it sits above the trachea. It hangs the trachea by the cricotracheal membrane. It is anterior to the laryngopharynx, and it is going to be at approximately the C4 through C6 vertebral level, but there is variation amongst individuals. The laryngoskeleton consists of 9 major cartilages and some minor cartilages. These include the thyroid cartilage, which sits atop the cricoid cartilage. As we spin this around and look posteriorly, we can see that connecting to the thyroid cartilage is the epiglottic cartilage. Here's the cricoid cartilage in the posterior, which it is more robust, so that is the top of the cricoid cartilage. And upon the cricoid cartilage is the arytenoid cartilage on either side. And atop the arytenoid, the corniculate cartilages. And then there is an aryepiglottic fold there, and within, the cuneiform cartilages. These are all hyaline cartilage, and they actually begin to calcify at about 18 years of age. Now let's look at some of the features of the laryngoskeleton. Let's start with the thyroid cartilage because it is a massive component to the larynx. The thyroid cartilage is only complete anteriorly and laterally. It consists of 2 laminae which come together along the midline anteriorly, and there is a robust piece of cartilage there known as the laryngeal prominence. This is colloquially referred to as the Adam's apple. As we move posteriorly, we see that there are 2 sets of horns. There are superior horns. These superior horns are going to ally with the greater cornua, or horns of the hyoid. And then there are inferior horns that are going to form a joint called the cricothyroid joint with the cricoid cartilage. That cricoid cartilage is the only element of the laryngoskeleton that is complete 360 degrees about the airway. And posteriorly, this cricoid lamina is the base upon which the arytenoid cartilages sit. The epiglottic cartilage has a stem and a leaf, and that is going to articulate with the thyroid cartilage anteriorly. Let's take a look at those arytenoid cartilages. They are very important structures for the function of the larynx. They are the most kinetic elements of the larynx. There is some motion at the cricothyroid joint, but not as much as with these arytenoid cartilages. So as we look at them superiorly, we see that they have 2 important processes. Anteriorly, there are vocal processes, and posterolaterally, there are muscular processes. The vocal processes attach to a vocal ligament, which then attaches to the thyroid cartilage. Those vocal ligaments are going to be the basis for the vocal cords. So once they are invested by mucosa of the larynx, as well as some of the intrinsic musculature, they become the vocal cords. These muscular processes are structures upon which some of the intrinsic laryngeal muscles may attach so that they can affect the motion of the arytenoid cartilages. These arytenoid cartilages, they may pivot, so we see them pivoting their vocal process outward there. And as they do, the vocal ligaments and hence the folds are going to abduct, or they may be pivoting medially, and that vocal ligament and the vocal folds will adduct. So this will either expand the rima glottidis, or this space, or it will narrow it. Also, as accessory cartilages atop the arytenoid, there are craniculate cartilages and then cuneiform cartilages. These help to maintain patency of the laryngeal inlet. So we've discussed the major elements of the laryngoskeleton, the individual cartilages which comprise it, some of their more important features, as well as how these cartilages move with respect to one another. This is your summary slide, and I thank you for your time.